Hey everyone, this is Ivan from Yellowfin, and in this video, I'll present some of the key highlights from the Yellowfin 9.7 release. We are launching a new major feature called Guided Natural Language Query in the Yellowfin platform. Guided NLQ provides a simple way for anyone to ask hard questions of their data. You can access it when you're creating Yellowfin content, or you can access it from the Create menu, which is available everywhere on the Yellowfin platform. Let's go ahead and ask a question. If you're asking questions with Guided NLQ for the first time, there is in-product assistance available to help you get started. So if you're wondering what types of questions you can ask, simply scroll down to the relevant sections. Animated tutorials on how to ask questions are also included. From your list of data models across the platform, you can select anyone to start your questions with. Let's explore this Yellowfin view on liquor sales. Note that you can select focus areas for your questions. In the view, Yellowfin allows you to create filters and group them together into a filter group. That's known as a view-defined filter group, and they're useful when you create reports because you only need to drag one filter group and all your filters are applied at once. Similarly, you can select them as focus areas here so that you don't need to specify them again in your questions. One of the major differences with Guided NLQ is that you're not staring at a blank search bar, wondering what to do next. You immediately get guidance on a type of question you might want to ask. For example, do you want to ask descriptive questions like, how are sales going for this year? Or the list of stores that are doing exceptionally well this quarter? Or perhaps some variance analyses between top brands? The initial menu here provides the guidance you need with different analysis types to get you going. Let's ask a question about sales performance across products. You'll immediately notice that there is no need to guess the right term to ask, or hopefully hit the right synonym. That's because Guided NLQ is powered by a metadata layer, the Yellowfin view. Firstly, it gives you the top 5 fields that are most popular in this view. With the Show More button, the dropdown also gives you all the available fields you can select to construct your question. So you can start selecting the fields you want, or can start typing without clicking on anything and the engine will autocomplete for you. There is no need for the engine to be trained on synonyms or for it to guess your intent. It gets it right every single time because the engine draws from metadata from the view. Now, you can use your mouse to click your way through the question or use the keyboard to type, or both at the same time, whichever feels the most comfortable to you. As you construct the question, the contextual guidance is displaying the most appropriate question options at every step of the process. The button also provides tips on what to look out for if the question seems incomplete, and in this case, I have not specified a time period. Alright, so let's look at the sales breakdown by product category for this year. Here we get the answer with an auto-generated best practice chart. You can go back and edit the question at any time, add more fields. You can also delete the options to change the question around or say you want to look at sales by account segment instead. Simply click on what needs to be changed and select it from the dropdown or type it in and let autocomplete take care of it. Based on the insights you get from this answer, you can do a few things. You can immediately ask new questions by starting again, or even jump to a different view to ask questions on different parts of your business. Guided NLQ is not tied to anything, not a dataset, a workbook, or to a piece of UI, you can query all of your data across the platform. Let's focus on this answer and see what you can do with it. You can change your display and see the data in tabular form, or save it into a report for now and come back to it later. You can also take this answer into a new report with a single click and continue your exploration right now in the Advanced Report Builder. Or if you were building content previously, you can also add it directly into your dashboards, stories, and presentation with a single click. The experience across all three are similar, so let's take a quick look at adding this to a dashboard. It's first going to prompt you to save this answer into a report as it is a new analysis, and then it's going to pull up a list of dashboards to insert this into, or can create a new one with it. Let's go with this dashboard. It immediately brings up the dashboard in draft mode with the new NLQ report highlighted, ready for a quick drag and drop into the dashboard. Super easy. For dashboards, we have also enhanced all Canvas widgets and action buttons with a new click event called Ask a Question, You can also specify the default view to use as part of this click event. This allows you to create dashboards and presentation experiences where consumers can go from seeing data to asking the next question by clicking on these widgets and engaging Guided NLQ directly. Since we're already here, let's now take a look at the complexity of analysis supported by Guided NLQ. For example, I might want to know which brands are actually having growth in sales this month compared to the last. This is an example of a question that's easy to ask in our heads, but it's actually a little bit time-consuming even for a data analyst to put together. Why? Because you are dealing with cohort analysis and additional calculations for growth and decline. Now, not only is that automatically done for you with Guided NLQ, with the answer showing brands that experienced growth this month, but it's also ranked by the respective percentages of growth. Again, providing a simple way for anyone to ask hard questions of their data. Let's now ask a final question and see how we have included more automated analysis into Guided NLQ. For example, showing the daily sales performance for the brand Johnny Walker for this year. Now, that will give you the answer, which is great, but what if you wanted to know about the outliers in your sales performance over time? In Guided NLQ, you can ask the engine to perform various automated highlights, like highlighting specific values, trends, segments, and in this example, let's go for outliers and step averages in this year's sales. So besides showing the daily sales performance, it now automatically highlights the days where there have been sales outliers for you to be aware of. You can perhaps explore further in the Advanced Report Builder, put this into a story, or even share this with a colleague. Besides being available in all of our content builders, Guided NLQ was also designed to be fully embeddable and customizable by a JavaScript API, so you can insert it into any application that you have. In this release, Yellowfin Stories have been enhanced with Guided NLQ integration. Let's take a look. As you write your story, you might need a new piece of analysis that you have not created before. You could always go into the Report Builder and create one with this workflow, but in Yellowfin 9.7, you can immediately ask natural language queries within stories. Let's ask a quick question similar to the one we've seen just before. The workflow guides you to save this as a new report and immediately adds a chart into your story, enabling you to stay in your flow as you ask questions of your data. For embedded reports in your stories, we have also introduced a quick way for consumers to jump into any report with the open report workflow. And once they're done performing their analysis, they can return to the story with a single click. For data discovery, we have included a few enhancements to help you further customize your charts and reports. For conditional formatting on tabular reports, we have included support for negative values in your bar formatters. Let's take a quick look at this one showing year-on-year growth. In 9.7, you can now apply the appropriate rules for negative values and it will visually display both positive and negative scenarios for bar conditional formatting. Let's look at another report and go into the chart builder here. In previous releases, some non-auto charts, meaning charts that you specifically select from a chart selector, did not support most of the chart functions available to auto charts. In 9.7, we have included support for average, accumulation, and trend chart functions for non-auto area, bar, and column charts. Let's take a look at this stacked vertical column chart showing sales by month and premium category. Now in 9.7, you can simply drag any of these chart functions here, and let's pick trend, and drop it into the axis box. You can then modify the respective settings, say 2 pixels for the lines with solid lines instead of dashes, and voila, you can see the premium category is trending upwards towards the end of the year. Let's switch over to this report, which is showing the sales figures for this month versus last month, and the difference between the two for each premium category. A great way to visualize comparisons like these is through a waterfall chart. In this release, we have added a new start column as you compare last month versus this month in this example, and you can now see the initial stage. We have also included support for custom colors for every bar here, helping consumers quickly understand that despite having overall growth this month, the super premium category experienced a decrease in sales. For data prep, we have redesigned the navigation menus in the View Builder, allowing you to manage every performance, security, and automation setting for your data models in one place. In previous releases, to perform field formatting actions, you had to traverse between the model and prepare stages in some scenarios, and if you wanted to perform formatting edits for multiple fields, you had to do so for each one at a time. In this release, we have greatly simplified this process. Firstly, you can manage both Assisted Insights and Guided NLQ capabilities with the same menu. Then, every field in your data model, metrics, and dimensions are managed in one single pop-up. You can quickly edit the field descriptions here and save them. We've also included quick formats for the most popular actions done by our customers. For example, two decimal places for a metric, or changing it to a percentage with the appropriate suffix, or into various financial formats. You can do so in a single click. For more custom formats, you can set those by clicking on Custom. All other field formatting, including custom colors, can also be done here. You can manage view and dependent content security permissions here. For example, restricting this view to only these groups and users with their respective access levels. The Filter Settings tab allows you to manage all row-level security settings in one pop-up. For example, setting one for this particular field, and you can even manage the field values each user has access to directly from this menu as well. Next is the ability to optimize your view performance in one centralized menu. And last but not least, view metadata and the entire list of dependent content for auditing purposes is available here as well. As part of this enhancement, we have also included the option to access all of these menus directly from the browse page. Except for data modeling activities, you can perform the same actions we just saw before and submit them without even entering the data model, saving you time and effort by making it unnecessary to enter the data model and republish it for actions like these. In this release, we have added support for multi-chart canvas and tabular reports. So from within the timeline, you can click into the reports directly. Entering the report, you immediately see the multi-chart canvas appearing in front of you. There is a filter button at the top, which allows you to track the filtering done on the report itself. Clicking on that opens up the filter panel. So let's set this to maybe premium categories and also for standard bottle sizes. The navigation menu at the bottom allows you to cycle through every single chart on the report. Firstly, you can go into the tabular report and look at the data. You can see the entire report over here. Also use the restyled sliders at the top to change between pages. You can also drill into these reports by clicking on the hyperlinks. So drilling from product category into kilos, to independent store types and chains, and into a particular account name within Walmart. Now, it might be a bit difficult to track the drill paths that you've done so far, so the drill paths button at the top tracks this for you. With this, you can track where you are within the hierarchy, jump into any level, or return back to the start at any point. You can use the left and right arrows at the bottom to look at each chart and interact with them. All the drills that you saw done on the report before is also applicable on charts as well. The menu at the top allows you to favor a report, engage discussions with other colleagues on this particular report itself, and even share it with other users in the system. You'll be able to see also the metadata for this report, tracking when it was created, who modified it recently, and where it lives within the Yellowfin platform. The parent menu has been updated to include a new report section alongside your timeline, signals, stories, discussion streams, and people sections. Clicking to it gives you a mini browse page where you can tap on the filter at the top to look at specific reports that are either your favorites, recently viewed, or the newest ones created within the platform. You can also change the layouts from thumbnail to list reports if you like, and also search for particular reports using the search button at the top. You can simply type into it or click on the previous searches that you've done before to save you time. So let's look for the NLQ report that we did earlier in the video and view it within the mobile app. The mobile app now supports reports created by users within the system, as well as the ones automatically created by Guided NLQ. And that's it for key highlights today. For all other enhancements and improvements in Yellowfin 9.7, you can view the release notes on our website and join the conversation in our community. Don't forget to check out our wiki, blog, and resources page for more information on Yellowfin. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.